So, we're beginning a next char. This is called Char Tanto. If you had the book, and for those of you who don't, I do have copies of this char, and also available at a discounted price are copies of this, of the two sets. Get one set, get one of the first volume here of those of you who are interested in going through this, because the tip really covers it pretty nicely for people, especially as we're getting started. Some of these things can get a little complicated, but I'm really excited about those, because what I really want to have is the ability to have a conversation and so be able to see all the ramifications it's had both in psychology and social positioning, as well as, you know, the most important fundamental part is to be able to learn how to affect the Tikkun in the world. So you need to know this. And when we get to Char Tanto now, we're all going to be talking, we're going to be start talking about the Kav, the Ein Sof, and that Levush which surrounds it, which we're calling Ak. So I think we should just get started. So just a couple of things I want to say as a Hakdama, as a preface. One is that when you're learning something like this, for the first time particularly, you just have to keep in mind that this is a very small part of a very big picture. But what happens is at the beginning of this is that you're learning the fundamental roots of the big picture. So that all the things that you learn here are applicable elsewhere in more refined places that are closer to home. Things that we could actually use to develop ourselves. But these lies, so that's one thing. And we have to think about these sometimes in just terms of principles, they're rules. Maybe they don't make sense. This is not deductive reasoning. The Rav is telling us something, it's opening up a tremendous, tremendous vast door. And he's going to try to help us find a way that we can become closer to this light. Now, I had said other times that there are two ways that the Rav gives us to be able to understand our relationship with the Almighty. One way is through anatomy. And then we're going to see here. We're going to start talking about the anatomy of Ak and the relationship, the anatomy of the Ak, to the Oros, which are inside, the lights of the Ein Sof Baruch Hu, which are inside of him. But there's another way, too, that we haven't really talked about at all, and it's going to come out here in Char Tanto a little bit. We're going to start seeing the fundamentals of this, which is the concept of the letters. Because the universe is really made out of letters and relationships to them. And we understand as we go further into the limud of Kabbalah, that how the letters, I mean, it's something I'm trying to get a hold of, is how words, letters, different patterns of sounds, different patterns of letters themselves, or how they're put together, how it is that they hold light and they work. So we're going to start seeing this now in Char Tanto. So I'm going to read the first paragraph up above, and then we'll read the light print down below. This will start that way. A lot of times I just read both everything down below. So let's start this way, and we'll see how it goes. Inyanim. So now we're going to learn the inyan of this concept, which is called Tanto. Da'aki ein mitziyu siru kumas adem ba'olam shlo yiyya b'chlols arba b'chinos. So there is no form, what's image, siru, of the stature of a man in the universe, shelo yihiyah bo klalos arba bechinus elo, that doesn't have within him the general root, generality of these rules, asher kolonim kol atzilus v'kol olamos, that it has all the atzilus, all things that are distanced out in some way from the Ein Sof Baruch Hu, and all of the universes that are in the spaces. And we've talked about the space a bit. So here they are. It's a new idea. First one is Shem Av. That's what we call Av. And how do we get Av? Well, you could take, and the Tiv will explain it better for us, but we could take the name Yudke Bavke, and he's going to give us four different ways we could spell that name. Now, the ways that these are spelled, again, have to do with the transfer of light from different places, from the Ebishter, from the Most High, which we could call this Rom HaMa'alos, the highest place, that the most interior place is closest to the Ein Sof. And here's the first one. It's called Av. Av is a number. It's 72. If you add up these numbers, you had Yud Vav Dal is 20, K Yud is 15, Vav Yud Vav is 13, and K Yud is 15. It adds up to 72. Then there's another one, very similar, which is called Sag, which is the gematria of the number 63, Gazette. So this is almost exactly the same word, but it's the same spelling, Yud Vav Dalet Ke Yud. But the Vav, instead of Vav Yud Vav, is spelled Vav Aleph Vav Ke Yud. If you want to have questions about this or why it's like that, then that's what it's called Ma. And it's written like this. It's number 45. Ma is 40 plus 5 is 45. Kazet. Yud Vav Dalet Ke Aleph Vav Aleph Vav Ke Aleph. This is called the Milui of Alofim. Filling up the name Yud Ke Vav Ke in what is called a Milui. We're going to be talking about this now. And with all the letters that were originally a Yud are now changed to an Aleph. And then the last one is the Shem Ben Kizay Yud Vav Dalet KK Vav Vav KK. This comes out to the number Ben, which is 52. So here we have four different names: 72, 63, 45, and 52. Okay, so those are names. Now the name Ben, this is the way that's pronounced. This name is Ben, is pronounced by the Sfardim. Most of us have a tradition that we're learning from Sfardim. It's not 100% true. The Ashkenazim refer to this as Ban. Instead of Ben, it's Ban. But I always use Ben because that's the way I learned it. Now let's look at the Tiv. We'll look at the light print in the Tiv, and we're going to go to the Tiv through Aleph, Beit, and Gimel, and then we're going to see what he's talking about. He says, Shar Tanta. So Tanta, he says, who Roshe Tevos, Tamim, Nikudos, Tagim, Osios. Now all these things, these different ideas, have to do with letters and words. He named his Bayer B'Sefer Yetzira. So he says a Perek Gimel in Mishnah Taz, the Taz is 16. Sha'osios Nikra of Nikroim Avonim. The letters are called stones. Asher Haim Bonim Teva Shlema, that you could use the stone, the stones, to build a complete word. Kikahu HaSeder Shekol Teva Morkeves Mekama Osios. So we understand that every word is a combination of multiple letters. So every word then has four different qualities that can be adjectives, so to speak, about these words. Tamim. So what is that? Tamim is really more like the music, a certain type of music. That's the way I see it. Maybe too high for us to really be appreciate what that music is, because you know they say that there are eight notes. In the basic Mikdash of Mizmor Shir al Shminis on the eighth. So what did the eighth represent? Well, there's only seven. We only have seven notes in our scale. So how do you get to the eighth? What is it? Well, it's a tam. These are tamim. All these notes, these musical notes, are tamim. Then there's the sounds, a specific sound which is called nekudos. And those nekudos are a, like we say, like the sound of we have a, like that. Those are the nekudos, and they actually are a greater adjective into the word to let you see what it sounds like. And then you have the concept of tagim, which is a tagim, is a dot or some kind of a formation at the top of a word, and then a letter, and then finally you have osios. So this is the word tanta. These are different definitions of words. Shehem Arba Madrega Zutachazu. Now these are actually levels. So the highest level is the Tamim, and the next level is the Kudos, and the next level is the Tagim, and then the Tagim are going to give way to the Osios, which is the lowest level. So all of these things are interchangeable with other ideas or can be applied in other ways, because first he started out by saying there's four, he's number four, right? Four different ways of spelling Yudke Vavke. Av Sag Mal Ben. Now he comes and he says there are also four different formations that have to do with words, which is called Tanta. So now we go to number Bet. B'kol Pratu Pratcha B'kol Olamos V'Hanatzalim Ba'olam. So all of the universes and all of the details that we find spread out throughout the universe. Mina Olam Nikra Ak. And this is starting for the first world, which we call Ak. Ad Sof Kan Nat Solom, until you get to all of the end of all the things that are developed in that Parzufim B'Olamos, and the different systems of transferring light, which I'm going to use that definition to try to talk about the word Parzuf. The Hainu Ad Ha'olam Atatam Ashafel Shabo Nimsa Ha'adam Agashmi. That is that all of these things, all of these different places, that are developed, that are going to be developed. And we said, so we went back to the hollow, we said, there's a line inside of this hollow, there's an Adam Kadmon, and this Adam Kadmon is going to develop in that. You can go all the way out from Adam Kadmon until you come down to this lower world where we live. B'kulam yesh arba b'chinas halul. All of them have these in some way, some manifestation of these four b'chinas. Shehin tamim nekudos tagim and osios. So now it says ve'eluhem shem ha've'eluhem. Now he says that these are the formations that we want to talk about. There's a shem av kazeh yud vav dalet ke yud vav yud valet ke yud. The shem sag kazeh. This is the number of 63. Yud vav dalet ke yud vav al vav ke yud. B'shem ma, which is the number 45. Kazeh yud vav dalet ke aleph vav al vav ke aleph. B'shem ben kazeh yud vav dalet ke vav vav ke ke. So he says, let me explain. Hine shem havaya efshel l'maloso b'kama mini miluyim. Now we have a new word. This is the word miluyim. So you could take a simple letter, yud, right? But yud is not spelled simply. It's yud vav dalet. So we have now yud vav dalet, and that's called the milui of the letter yud. Ha'echad hu b'milui yudin. So the first one is called the milui of yudin, and he shows it to us again. Yud vav dalet ke yud vav yud vav ke yud. This is also known as av. She'odah v'gematria shivim b'shtayim. If you count it up, it comes out to be 72. V'hu shem av. This is a name called av. V'hasheni hu b'milui yudin v'alef. It's the milui yudin starts out the same way, but when you get to the vav, it changes. It's yud vav dalet ke yud, vav alef vav ke yud. She'olah v'gematria shishim v'shlosh. So it comes out to be 63. V'hu shem sag. It's called the name sag. V'ashlishi hu b'milui alofim kazeh. It's yud vav dalet ke alef, vav alef vav ke alef. It's called the milui of alofim. She'olah v'gematria arboyim v'chemesh. V'hu shem ma. This is the call of the shem ma. So these are four names of Hashem. Here comes the fourth one. So it's a milui where we call this as a milui of hayin. When you fill out the word, you make it into a milui. Milui means to fill it out, right? So you fill out the word, it's spelled like this. Kazeh, yud vav dalet kk, vav vav kk. If you take that word, she'olah b'gematria chamisha b'shnayim, so it comes out to be 52. B'hu shem ben, this is called ben. Shem ben gam nikra havaya kafula. So it's also called a double havaya. Why? V'shtei pamim havaya, because havaya is a gematria of 26. So if you take 26 and multiply it by 2, you get the ben again. It comes back to 52, ola ben. V'gam ki os yud b'milui, also the letter yud vav dalet. If you look at the milui of the base yudin, B'shar ha'osyas heim osyas kefulos mamash, so all the rest of them are going to be double letters. So that one is the yud, is a new product, but v'gam ki os yud b'milui, if you take the milui of those yud, it's actually two yuds. I said it wrong, so it's actually two yuds. In other words, yud vav dalet comes out to be 20. So it's also kefulos, so it's, in other words, it's two yuds, makes 20. And then you have b'shar ha'osyas heim osyas kefulos mamash, which is two k's, two vav's, at 2 k's again, so you have, once again, let me say it so that I got it straight, is yud vav dalet is makes 20. 20 is actually 2 yud, so that's a double yud. And then the other two are k and k, vav vav and k k. That's the name ben. So now let's go to the top, and we'll do number dalet. V'nei elu arba havayas and nechlokos v'arba miluyim ha'elu. So now these are havayas, and we could change them into four different kinds of miluyim. Hey, bechinas tamim. So the tamim go with the name av. Bechinas nekudos goes with the name sag. Bechinas tagim shem ma. Bechinas osio shem ben. Bechain v'kol echad me'elo arba havayos kolum mikulum. So each one of them actually has all the rest of them. We'll see what he means by all the rest of them. But we have a concept that we've heard about before. Is that if you took Kesser has 10 spheros in it. So all the 10 spheros have 10 spheros. This is slightly different. He says that the name the word tanta is that all has all of the four has a tanta, the tamim has a tanta in it. And now he says in Avaya it also has these four. Let's see what he says in number Dalad in the Tiv in the light print. So he says, La'el bi'arnu ki shem havaya nechloch la'arba miluyim shehem av sag ma'u ben. So we said that we could take a vibe, we could make it into four different ways. Now trust me that this could be used a lot. This is a basic fundamental principle, and the idea of the of this, which we pronounce asmab, that's one of the ways, that's how we would refer to it, which we want to say that all four of the names together, asmab, that corresponding to these miluyim, Yeshnam arba b'chinas tanta. There's also a tanta that corresponds to them. Tamim nekudas tagin in osias, which we again, in abbreviation, we call a tanta. Bovin shabachinah b'shona shehiba b'chinas tamim. So it goes like this: the tamim him b'chabekubonas connected shem avaya b'milui diyudin. So it corresponds to the name avaya, and this shem avaya that we see in the milui of yudin, which is av shuhu shem av. So Tamim, which would be the first sound, which I said is a musical note of some sort, it's just pure music, that's my thinking, goes along with the name Av. So the second one is going to be called the Nekudos, which is the sounds that are underneath or up above or in the middle of the letter. So this corresponds to the name Sag, which is 63. Which is the second milui. So the third one is called tagim. The tagim is the spot, is the dots that are up above the letters. So this goes along with the third milui, which is the name ma. So the last one of the letters of the tanta. The tanta, again, it's tagim, and nekudos, it is tamim, nekudos, tagim, and osios. It goes along with the four letters of four different names of asma. Shehim akuvanis kenega de midlui al ribi shuhu shem ben. Bofen shenitna de kenos es aor b'shne minikinuyim. So now, we're going to talk about light, and we have two different light, he said, right? Because we're talking about the light of the ansof. Now we have two different standards in which we can describe this light. One is tanta, o ba'arba shemos asmab, which is av sag ma'u ben, o ba'arba b'chinas tamim nekudas tagim osios, or the tamim, or the tanta. So we can either use asmab or tanta, and each are describing different levels of light. So we have number hey now. So let's read the light print on number hey. So he says, "Kashem shekol havaya nechlech as the arba milui havaya." So you take any havaya, you could divide it into an asma. Kamo kain kol echad me'elu arba miluyim. So the same way, each one of these miluyim nechlech gamku la arba miluyim. So each one of them has four miluyim in it. Vovin sheshem av atzma kolam arba shemo shehem asma da av. So he says that shehem av da av sag da av mav da av and ben da av. V'chein sag kolam arba shemo. So then you could have a sag, a level which is called sag, and it's going to have asma in it too, which is av the sag the sag, ma the sag and ben the sag. Are the same thing. There's going to be an Abda Ben, and there's going to be the Sagda Ben, and the Mada Ben. So in other words, the short version of this is called an Asmab of Ma. And there will also be an Asmab of Ben. So now if you add them up, there are 16 of them. Because each one of the four is divided into four, 4 times 4 is 16. So for example, you could take tanta, do the same thing. There's a tanta of the tanta, there's a nikudin of the tanta. Let's see how he says. Excuse me, I said it wrong. So he said, tamim, the tamim, the nikudis the tamim, the tagim the tamim, the osios the tamim. So you're going to have and tagim of osios. Also going to be a tanta of the tagim. There's going to be a tanta of the osios. There's going to be a tanta of the nekudos. Now we call erem la arba bechinas tanta. Boven sheshem av the av. Let's take the av of the av. Hu tamim the tamim. V'shem Sav Da'av would be the Nekudas the Tame. V'shem Ma Da'av who Tali the Tame. V'shem Ben Da'av who Osius the Tame. It's Osius the Tame. V'shem Mischalkim Kulom Al Zera Derek. So you can mix them all together. And what we're preparing here is different kinds of formations of the dispersal of light or the light of different variations. It's difficult to understand. This is a very high level to be able to see it, but we have the names for it. So we have one level of light, which is called Tanta. It starts with Tamim, and then it goes down to the Osius. And that can be mixed up. Each one of them has its own Tanta. And then you have also the Asmat, and each one of them has an Asmat. But not only that, but the Asmat itself will have relationships to the Tanta, because they're going the same. There's four of them, they're going the same direction. Let's look at number Vav. We have a few more minutes. Let's look at number Vav. Bina kar kafta shel zeha adam kadmo. Now let's start looking at the anatomy. What we learned previously to this about Tanta and the Asma. These are tools that we're going to need as we go forward to be able to understand how they work. And without trying to get it in too detail and too deeply, just consider it as a rule. These are different rules. Everything has everything else in it. So hines hakar kafta, so that's the top of the skull, shel zeh adam kadmon, shehu rosho, ad makom b'chinas aznaim shavah, so let's take, here's my head, right, the top of my head, down to my ear, shelo hu nikra b'chinas shem av, so this is the av of adam kadmon, v'hu b'chinas sod ha-tamim shavah k'nizgar, so just what we said before, so that the av of adam kadmon is also the tamim of adam kadmon. So that we said that the Tamim are going to have
all the other four. So if we had a distance between here and here, we're going to find a way that we could have the Tamim going to be at the very top, and then the Sag of the Tam is going to be slightly below and moving downwards. But at this level, we don't talk about it. That doesn't mean that it's not talked about at all, because the Leshen, for example, does go into a great detail. It's a tremendous mind. Somehow, a Lithuanian that had, I don't know, I'm not really sure what his background is or how he got to this, but we do know that Vilna Gaon is a Mekubal, even though we see all the Litvish yeshivas and none of them learn any of this and know anything about it. But nonetheless, many of the Talmidim of the Grod did, because he taught them. Let's look over here in number Vav. In the light print. So this is the light print in the Tiv. He named his bar Sheyeshnam Taz Bechinas Nechlalos Ba'arbor Shemus Asmab. Bechin Yeshnam Taz, that is 16 Bechinas and Nechlalos Ba'arbor Bechinas Tanta. So each of them are four, and they can be divided each one into four. Ba'yaday Taz Bechinas Elos. So if you take these 16 Bechinas, Yored HaShefa Melamala Lamanta. So what's happening is the Shefa, now with this word Shefa, we're going to see it a lot. Shefa refers to the bounty or the blessing, or I haven't got the right word exact, but it means really like a flow of the bounty, of the goodness that Hashem wants to give, is coming from the up above, down below. So we see that you start with Tamim, it's the highest level. And you're going to see that Osi is going to be the lowest level. And you're going to see that Av is going to be the highest level, and that Ben is going to be the lowest level. So there's some concept of up and down here. Va'ata nivayer hechon hu makomo shel taz b'chinas elu b'kumas ak. So now what we want to know is that since we have a Tanta, and since we have an Asma, we want to know in relationship to Adam Kadmon, where are they? Shehu amakor litzias v'hizgalos kol ha'oris ha'lalu. Because ak is the root. It's the origin of all reality, the way that we can understand it, our ability to understand it. But v'hine ha'cheluk ha'ele b'yoser shebekumas ak, shuhu metzkilis ha'rosh ta'ak, v'ad'b'chines aznayim shebo. Again, so the upper, most highest part, which would be from the ears upward, actually from the top of the head down to the ears, hu nikra kar kafta. So this is called the top of the skull. Something like that, the very top of the head. I don't know the best English word for it. B'sham kubba b'chinu shem av. That is where you find the av. Av is like the highest possible level.
Kem Shashem Av, Hu Hashem HaElyon B'Yosef, we call the Arba Miluyim, the Shem Abaya, because we said before that the Asma really works in an order from top to bottom. As this is the top part, if you looked at it in relationship to Adam Kadmon, this name would represent it. And remember, Av is not just a name. Av is Yud Vav Dalet, Ke Yud Vav Yud Vav Ke Yud. So you have, actually, the Shef is coming out of a place of letters. There's another way to talk about it. You could say they're tamim. Ki shame av mekavim kenega bechinas tamim keniskar. So if you had the shame av here, yud, ke, vav, ke, and it's milui, as we say, yud, vav, dalek, ke, yud, vav, yud, vav, ke, yud, and then you have tamim, nekudos, tagim, and osios, they would correspond to each other. They'd be in the same place. Or one opposite the next, or maybe interchangeable in some way. So the Av itself has a distance between the top to the ear. This is the it has, so it has its own asma. So the asma, a canal shehem tanta, which also would be correspond to the four different names. The asma would correspond to tanta. So then now he has to explain how it gets divided up into the four different aspects of Tanta. And not like he said before that it's only a name Av. Now you can mix in these two things together and we're going to have to see it because although Tanta is not in the forefront of everything, on the other hand, in many ways it is, so we have to see how it works. Amlon is Barakan Inyan Zeh, so one wants to say like this. He's not really explaining this. But Tam Shabaim Rishus to Daba Bemakom Zeh, so the place from the Aznayim upwards to the Karkafta, we don't really have permission to talk about it particularly. But Prat Machma Shabatoch Diburu Beinyan the Karkafta, the Ak, and the reason why is because in the midst of the words that we're going to use to talk about the Karkafta, the Ak, Yavul the Daba Beinian Hasaros, then you started talking about the hairs on the top of the head of Ak, Shal Gabi Akar Kafta, they're on the top of it, Beinian Lachut, Hachut, Ein Sof, Haniknas Besoch Ak, and then you'll have the concept of the Ein Sof that's inside of Ak, Gavar Be'arna, the El Shein, Bedabrim, Klaal Beinian Chut, the Ein Sof, so we already said that we're not going to talk about what's inside of Ak. So therefore, he's only going to speak in general terms. Now let me see how long this is, because I don't want to go too far over on the time. So let's look a little bit more. I find this very, very exciting, and I'm hoping that it's understandable on the other side. So, number Zion, he said, V'hine afal pi she'anu korem makanem kenuyim elu. So now we're saying these words, and we're using these substitute names. It's the word kinui. Could go in Adam. So like, for example, we have this word Adam Kadmon. Adam means a man, right? But a rosh, and then we have a head, and then we have a znaim, and ears, and inayim, v'kiyotu, kushara, kinuyim, all of these things. So we can't say this too many times, that it doesn't exist actually in any way that we could try to metamorphize it, anthropomorphize it to ourselves. It's something completely spiritual and not physical. The only thing is that it has a relationship, a direct correlation to us, as best we can understand it. So therefore he's using this, and he uses the phrase rock the shakek as a ozen, so that you'll have some, to quiet down your ears, so that you'll have some ability to be able to understand it. The shiyuvno devogim, so you should have some idea of these relationships. So therefore we have established these different names, makom gavoh, because in this very, very high level. Amnam Iker Makom Kinuyim Elohim Ma'olam Ratzil Lamata. So where do we actually find the use of these names? Would be in an Olam which is called Atzilus. A few times he's used the word Atzilus interchangeably with the different objects that we find, but there is an Olam called Atzilus, as we've said before. Shehu Min Arich Atzilus Lamata. Where is the long Olam of Atzilus? Olam of Atzilus is from the Erech Anpin of Atzilus, which covers the whole amount of Atzilus from the top to the bottom. Kimisham ve'eloch ye'bechinas partsif, because this is where systems develop. The aspects of a partsif. The partsif, as I said before, my definition is that it's a system for the transfer of line. Of a memen lamala, but when you come higher than Erech Anpin, Ein bechinas parts of klal, there is no real concept of a parts of a system that we could recognize. Rak the shakek as a ozen. So since we're talking about higher than Atzilus, because we're talking about Adam Kadmon, which is preliminary to Atzilus, so then we're talking about an Erech Anpin is really from the Tibor, the Akka Lamata. The Tibor means the belly button, so to speak, of Akka Lamata. So Anam Mekanim Elu Kinuyim Elu. So since we have no system, and he's going to explain why there's no system, because a system implies movement of light and kelim that hold the light, and we don't really see that or really understand. It's not over here, but nonetheless, we're going to talk about it. And tomorrow, with God's help, we'll start looking more inside of this shar called Tanta. Thanks for listening.